Hi friends, my name is Ratan. So in this video, we'll discuss about the string manipulations, right? The string manipulations, basically we'll discuss the four classes. One is the string class. What is the second class here? The string buffer class. The string class, string buffer class. The third one is the string builder class. The fourth one is the string tokenizer class. Tokenizer class, right? That's all. So as per the string manipulations, basically discuss the four classes: string, string buffer, and string builder and string tokenizer. Right? Good. In the last two videos, we just done the case one, case two. Right? Case one is what? String and string buffer. Small case. Case one. String and string buffer both are final classes. As you know, final class. Right? We cannot extend it. Both are final classes. And present which package? Java dot lang package. Right? That's it. Point number one. And the second video, we discuss case two. The string object, we have two ways to create a string object, right? What are the two ways? By using new operator and without using new operator, right? The second video we done, we can create the string object in how many ways total? Two ways. By using new operator, without using new operator, right? That's all. Now we'll discuss in case three. This is third video. We'll discuss about the case three. Okay, coming to the third case three here, we'll discuss about the mutable versus immutable. String is a immutable class here. String is mutable or immutable here? Immutable. Once you create a string object, it doesn't allow the modifications on existing object. Why string object is immutable, modifications allowed or not allowed here? Not allowed. But string buffer is a mutable here. Mutable means what? It allows the modifications, right? So the case 3 we'll discussing mutable versus what? Immutable, right? The case 3. So immutable versus immutable versus what? Mutable object. Mutable, right? String is which class here? String is immutable class. What about string buffer? The string buffer is a mutable. String buffer is a mutable, right? That's all. So what the reason? What the point here? If you take the string, string s equal Ratan. String s equal Ratan. I'll use the concat method. S dot concat. S dot concat of. I'll use soft. S dot concat of soft, right? Then system dot out dot println. I'm printing s. Then what is the output? Tell me now. Now what is the output here? S is Ratan. S dot concat of soft, right? Then I'm printing s. Then what is the output here? Just here you'll get the output is Ratan only. You'll get the output is what? Ratan. The concatenation allowed or not allowed here? Not allowed, right? Got it. See, the string is immutable. Immutable means modifications allowed or not allowed? Not allowed. Well, string is what? Immutable. Modifications are not allowed, right? What about string buffer here? If you take the string buffer, assume a string buffer, some Ratan is there. String buffer Ratan is there. So string buffer contains method is called append method. The string means what is the method name here? Concat method. String buffer means what is the method name here? Append method. Append of simply can make the Ratan, right? Simply this is soft. Soft here. Soft. That's it, guys. Then system dot out dot println. I'm printing sb here. I will do practically these points. The string means I'm using concat method, but still Ratan only printed because string modifications allowed or not allowed? Not allowed. Nature is called immutable. But string buffer, I'm printing sb, right? Sb means simply you'll get the output is Ratan soft only. Ratan soft means what? Modifications are allowed. Wait, modifications are allowed, right? That's all. So that nature is called which nature here? Mutable nature, right? That is called mutable versus what? Immutable. Yeah. Okay, but a small entry question is there. Ratan sir, you said string is immutable, modifications are not allowed. If the modifications are not allowed, then what is the purpose of the concat method? Wait, string concatenation is allowed or not allowed? Yeah? Concatenation is not allowed, right? Then what is the use of the concat method? The purpose of the concat method is, always combining the two objects. In front of we don't sit ideal. Just take the pen and paper, note down all the points. That's it. So the point here, the concat method is used to combine the two string objects. And it returns the new string data here. It returns what? A new string object, right? That's it. If you want, just you can check it here. See, s dot the method name is called what? Concat method, right? S dot concat of what? Soft. So concat method is used to combine these two string objects, and it returns the new string object, the string str. Now what's the value of the str here? Ratan soft. What is the value of the str? Yeah? Ratan soft, right? That's it. So that is the purpose of what? A concat method. Why point is clear? Concat is used to combine the two string objects and returning what? A new string, right? Then what is the value of the str? Ratan soft will be printed, right? Ratan soft will be printed. That's all, guys. One more small entry question. I hope the purpose of concat is clear, right? The concat is used to combine the two objects, returning what? A new string object. One more small entry question here. For example, as I said, string s equal to Ratan. Okay, string s equal to Ratan. S dot, the method name is called what? Concat method. S dot concat of what? Soft. S dot concat of what? Soft, right? Then in this case, I'm assigning this reference variable to s only. After concatting the data, I'm assigning to which variable reference variable here? S only, right? Then system dot out dot println of s. Then what is the output? Tell me. Observe carefully, try to analyze. With string manipulations here, always requires some analysis part. In entire Java, a bit analysis part is string manipulations only. Collections also very simple here. Collections are always inserting the data, reading the data, inserting, reading, that's it. But only it requires some analysis means that's string manipulations. Very interesting. So no, s dot concat, after concatting, I'm assigning to the s only, right? Then what is the output? You will get the Ratan or you will get the Ratan soft. Simply, the output is what? You will get the output is Ratan soft only. You get the output is what? Ratan soft. Ratan sir, you said string is immutable, modifications are not allowed. Then why this Ratan soft is printing? Why it is Ratan soft is printing? Actually, here also modifications are not allowed here. I'll give the reason here, you can check it. What the first object you are here? Just simply Ratan, right? What the reference variable for this Ratan here? Yes, sir. Okay, yes, right? Then what the second line? Concatenation. Okay, concatenation, s dot concat of soft. Then what happened? Internally in the memory, one object is created. Which object here? Ratan soft. Which object here? Ratan soft, right? Concatenation. So previously you can check it here. S dot concat of soft. What is the output? Ratan soft, right? Ratan soft, what is the reference variable? Str, right? Then str is pointing to Ratan soft. That is a normal case. But now, what is after concatenation? What is the reference variable here? S, right? S is already pointing to some object, right? Which object? Ratan object or not? S is already pointing Ratan object means then what happened here? This link is destroyed. That link is destroyed. This S is pointing its object here. S is reassigning reference variable, right? We are reassigning this reference variable to another object. S is already pointing to Ratan, right? Now it is pointing to what? Ratan soft or not? That's all, guys. Observe carefully. String is immutable. See, this is a fixed object, right? This object, you are doing any modifications? With this object, you are not doing any modification, right? With the modification, new object internally created or not? Yes, or no? That is called immutable only, right? Sanuya, this object modification is allowing or not allowing? Not allowing. With the modification, new objects are created or not? So that nature is called which nature here? Immutable nature, right? That's it, guys. My point is clear. Total, you have to focus on 3 points here. Point number one, immutable versus mutable. String is immutable, modifications are not allowed. Once you create the string object, on that object, modifications are not at all possible. But string buffer is a mutable, it allows the modifications. On the existing object only modifications are doing, right? That's all. If the modifications are not allowed, then what is the purpose of the concat method? Second point. The concat method purpose is what? Combining the two string object, returning the new string object. Returns what? A new string object, right? That's all, guys. The third one is what? This is an entry question, a mandatory entry question for the experience, guys. Maybe by seeing this output immediately, most of the guys are saying what? Ratan, right? Why they are saying Ratan? Because it is immutable, modifications are not allowed. Then they are saying what? Ratan only. But the output is what? Ratan soft. Output is what? Ratan soft, right? Good, good. So because the reference variable is pointing to the new object, it means on the existing object, we are not doing any modifications, right? That nature is called which nature here? Immutable nature. So these three cases, these 3 points, we are discussing case 3 here. In the case 3, how many points are there total? 3 points are there. Immutable versus mutable, concat method, reassigning the reference variable, right? I will do these 3 points practically. Just check the screen. In the previous video, we done the two classes, right? String manipulations, like the string operations or string manipulations. So this is a string video. Just let me open Edit Plus. The string operations video class 1 and video class 2 is done, right? Now we'll discuss the video class number 3. This is the video class number 3. Just check the previous two videos first. This is video class number 3. What I discuss here, immutable versus mutable, right? Anyhow, we are doing the practicals by using Eclipse IDE. Just let me open Eclipse IDE here. Eclipse, which version are we using here? Oxygen, right? Just let me open Eclipse IDE. We have the string operations, right? String operations or string manipulations here. This is JDBC. We have to switch the workspace here. We have to change the workspace. How to change the workspace? Tell me. File menu. Here we have the switch workspace. So string operations required. I'm switching to workspace, right? Good. I said the case number 3, we discuss about what? Mutable versus immutable, right? Mutable, right? That's all. String is immutable class here. But string buffer is what? String buffer. The string buffer is the mutable, right? That's it. So immutable means what? Modifications are not allowed. Mutable means modifications are allowed, right? That's all. I will do that example with the help of Eclipse IDE. This is Eclipse IDE. This is the last example. As you know, the project, right? I'm creating string example project here. Under that src folder is there. Under the package. What the package name here? com.dss, right? Under the package, just right click here. New. I want the class. This is my test 3 example. I want main method. Just to click on main method. Just click on finish, right? Click on what? Finish. That's it. Now, come to the application. If you want maximize this one, just double click here. Double click, right? That's it. Then come to the application here. So now I will write the string here. The string s equal to, I'll write as usual rather than s dot, the method name is called what? Concat method. Concat of, I said soft, right? That's it. After concatting the data, system.out.println yes. Okay, next one is what? A string buffer, right? How to get a string buffer object here? String buffer buffer equal to new string buffer of. So here also I'll add Durga. So in the string buffer means what the method name here? Simply can write the buffer dot. The method name is called append method. See, string means we have the concat method here. String buffer means the method is called which method here? Append method, right? That's it. Buffer dot append method. Okay. So simply here sysout control space. So buffer, right? That's it. Simply now we can run this code. What is the output you'll get? String is mutable or immutable? Immutable, right? Immutable. So modifications are not allowed, right? What about string buffer here? String buffer is the mutable. Mutable means what? Modifications are allowed. Simply run this code here. How to run this code here? Just right click here, run as Java application, right? That's it. Now test 3 I want run, just click on OK. But the first case here, we'll get the Ratan. Second case, what you'll get here? Durga soft, right? That's it. So no, first one is modifications allowed or not allowed? Not allowed, right? That's it. Good. If the modifications are not allowed, then what's the purpose of the concat method? Concat method used to combine the two objects. Right? Returns the new string object. Returns what? New string object, right? That's it. So if you want, let me write here the string str1 equal to Ratan, right? Now str1 is pointing to Ratan object. Then str1 dot, the method name is called concat method. Concat of soft, right? That's it. So concat method is used to combine these two string object and it returns what? New string object, right? String str2. Then what is the value of the str2? The sysout control space str2. Wait, then what is the value of the str2 here? Ratan soft, right? That's it. Here run button here. Directly click on run button, you'll get the output. Yes or no? That's it. I said one more third point, right? Some entry question. interview question. Interview questions. Coming to the interview question here, what the interview question tell me here? The string S1 is there. S1 equal Ratan. Okay, S1 equal Ratan. S1 dot, the method name is called what? Soft. Concat of soft. Okay. After concatting the data, I'm assigning to the same reference variable, S1. I'm assigning to what? Same reference variable, right? S1 is assigned. The sysout control space, print the S1, right? So no, print the S1 or not. Then what is the output you'll get here? Ratan soft only. The last line you can check it, we'll get the Ratan soft or not. Wait, it means modifications are not allowed here. First object, what I said, first object is Ratan. With the modification, new object is created internally. New object is created, that S1 is previously pointing to Ratan, that reference variable is destroyed, that S1 is pointing to the new object, right? So on the existing object, you are not doing any modifications, right? That nature is called nature, immutable. Okay, clear? That's all, guys. So string class, which class here? Immutable class. So in Java, the string class and all wrapper classes also. We have the wrapper classes concept later. All wrapper classes are switch classes, immutable classes. Okay, clear? That's all, guys. So in front of we don't sit idle here. Just take your laptop, do the practicals. In front of you, I'm doing all the practicals. I'm explaining the board first time. I'm doing the practicals second time. I'm repeating multiple times, right? Do the practicals properly. That's all. Total, how many cases done as of now? 3 cases. Case 1, so both are final classes. Both are final classes present in java.lang package. What the case 2 here? Two approaches to create object. What about case 3 here? Immutable versus what? Mutable, right? That's it. Immutable versus what? Mutable, right? That's all, guys. In the next case, we'll discuss about the equals method here. In the next case, we'll discuss about what? Case number 4, we'll discuss about the equals method. So instead of doing the half an hour videos, 1 hour videos, just I'm giving the cases here, case by case. It may take 15 minutes video, 10 minutes video, right? So clearly I'm dividing the videos. Don't think the more videos are there like that. More number of videos, right? So one of the students is coming, Ratan sir, collection 50 videos are there. Okay, but every video 15 to 20 minutes, right? There is no issues. So that's all, guys. Thank you, guys. Thanks for watching. And like the videos and comment the video. And subscribe to our channel to get the more updates. Thank you, guys. Bye.